Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also. Friends, we have gathered here today to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Charlie. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss, that God grant us grace that in pain we might find comfort, in sorrow we might find hope, and in death we might find the resurrection. Let us pray. O God, you gave us our birth, and you are ever more ready to hear us when we are to pray. And you know our needs even before we ask them, and our ignorance in asking. Give to us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death, and help us to live as those who are prepared to die, that when our days here are accomplished, we might be enabled to die as those who go forth to live, so that living or dying, our life may be in you, and that nothing in life or in death will ever be able to separate us from your great love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Charlene E. Agson, the daughter of Charles and Esther Almquist Seaman, was born in Great Bend on February 17, 1929, and passed away on May 3, 2000, at her residence in Larned. Charlene was raised in the Larned community and graduated from the Larned High School in 1946. On October 26, 1947, she married Gerald Leland, better known as Babe Agson. This union was completed at Larned, Kansas. And to this union, two children were born, Dave and Kay. Gerald passed away on March 23, 1985. Charlene was the owner of the Agson Jewelers, a member of the United Methodist Church, VFW, Larned Country Club, the Chamber of Commerce, called the Larned. She is survived by her son Dave and wife Denise of Concordia, her daughter Kay and husband Bill Moore of Sterling, 8 grandchildren, 2 step-grandchildren, and 1 great-grandchild. So many different things. She was willing to help us. She was a daughter's best friend. So one who has been there so often in the past, it is hard to let go of. One who was there is now no longer with us. We live by relationships. My mothers, fathers, brothers, sisters, fellow business people, neighbors. When death comes, it takes away one of those relationships. Our relationships are like roots that supply us with the nutrients of life. Like a piece of pie in our blood. Death comes, it takes one away, it takes a lot of time. Especially when we lose somebody by a sudden death. It's as though somebody has just grabbed a part of our body and ripped it right from us. That's how sharp this pain is in this family. First, there's the unbelief. This is not really happening. Then there's annoyance. Then finally, gradually, reality begins to sink. It takes time. Then we're here beside us for birthdays, anniversaries. But this year, especially for this family, there's going to be a number of graduations. Our life is made up of these events. Each time these events come back around, and we'll maybe reawaken. Although we say that in about 2 years' time we might be able to get past this element of grief, there's an element that says we never totally recover from our loss. Just as Charlene never totally recovered from the death of her husband. One of the things we have that helps us express this pain, this loss that we have, is our tears. God has given to us the ability to express our emotions in a way that no other animal in all of God's creation has been granted. That is tears. Kim has studied these tears, and they say the tears we shed from the expression of emotions poisons, the other tears do not. So if the tears are there, let them flow. We also need to understand the life of Charlene. We need to pick up on some of the cues of life, such as always being there with one another. It's difficult right now to handle our grief. We need to be there with each other. To handle the emotions of death, such as death and death. We need to be all thankful for the love of God. When somebody dies suddenly, there's always this other one. What if this one is done? What if that? Truth be known, we would all say if we had our brothers on how to die, we'd like to be too. remember and celebrate. Let us know that the same loving arms that embraces Charlene can also embrace us. Give us hope. Give us comfort. In the midst. For as we are in death, we are in life. From whom? From whence can we seek our help? Our help comes from the name of the Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus said, very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. Where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever sees me, the Father will honor. Almighty God, into your hand, and your daughter, Charlene, in a sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life. In Jesus Christ our Lord. This body we commit to the ground. Earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. But blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Yea, saves the Spirit, and we will rest in the way. Their works will be well. Christ have mercy upon us. Lord have mercy upon us. Let us join together in the Lord's prayer, each of us praying the same words that we are accustomed to. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Almighty God, look with pity upon the sorrow of your servants for whom we pray. Amidst things that we cannot understand, help us to trust in your care. Bless thus these members of this family, the friends of Charlene, and keep them. Make your face to shine upon them, and give them your peace. For this we ask in the one who is able to keep us from falling. One who is able to make us stand without blemish in the presence of God's glory with rejoicing. To the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, power, and authority, before all time, and now, and forevermore. Amen.